Here we're going to examine the molar solubility of barium chromate. And we're going to do it in two possible solutions. One's pure water, and we'll do that in this video, and then we'll do one where it's in a solution of sodium chromate, which is a common ion problem. This is a fairly straightforward problem. Oops, I don't know why I'm writing calcium. We'll try again. Barium chromate. Okay, it is the insoluble salt. It's easy to know it's insoluble because they gave me a Ksp value for it. That's a dead giveaway. It'll break apart into the two ions. Barium has got a +2 charge. Chromate has a 2- charge. I'm going to leave room for an ICE table, and I'm going to refresh my memory that anytime I write an equilibrium, I need to write the expression. So I will write it. There you go. When I set up my ICE table, I see what the initial I don't know the initial concentration because this is a solid. I dump some in before the reaction. It's in pure water, and there is no barium in pure water. There's no chromate in pure water, so those are legitimate zeros. I will dissolve some. S stands for molar solubility. How much of this dissolves? I produce here, and I produce here, and I end up with some S and S. Okay, so the Ksp, which is given to me as 2.1 times 10 to the minus 10 equals, what's the E line for barium? It's S. What's the E line for chromate? It's also S. So if I were to take the square root of 2.1 times 10 to the minus 10, I would have the solubility of this salt, 1.4 times 10 to the minus 5. Now, before we leave this problem, let's consider and think about part B. We are adding a common ion. By adding sodium chromate, which is soluble, we are going to be adding some of this. When you have this present, it pushes the equilibrium and decreases the solubility. So in part B, we're going to see how that happens.